The Westminster Shorter Catechism is a wonderful tool for teaching about the truths of God's Word. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6, it says this in verse 1. Now this is the commandment, the statutes, and the rules that the Lord your God commanded me to teach you, that you may do them in the land to which you are going over to possess it. And then skipping down to verse 7, you shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise. From the very beginning, God's people have been called, commissioned, and even commanded to teach the truth about God to the next generation. The Westminster Shorter Catechism is a tool that was designed back in the 17th century to do just that, to bring about the truth of God's Word, what it is He commands us to do, and what it is He calls us to believe, to our generation and to the next. And in this class, I'd like to be able to encourage you in that. And as you're looking to learn more about God's Word and to teach the next generation about God's Word, you may ask yourself the question, why a catechism? What is the significance of a catechism? Isn't a catechism a Roman Catholic thing? Why are we as Protestants using this? Isn't the Bible enough? And first of all, we have to say that yes, the Bible is enough. The Bible is altogether sufficient for us to understand who God is, what He wants us to believe, and what duty He requires of us. But He also teaches us that we are to teach one another with regard to the truth of who God is and what it is He commands us to do. That has been the case from very, very early on. And Protestants picked that up in the 16th century during the time of the Reformation. It was a time when there was widespread ignorance about doctrine and practice throughout the church. And the Reformers wanted to restore Christian education to the people in the pews. And the catechism was a tool. It was a means by which teaching and the teaching of the next generation could occur. And you might ask, is it biblical? Well, nowhere in the scriptures can we find a passage that says, thou shalt teach your children the Westminster Shorter Catechism. So if you're looking for that, you won't find it. But there are portions of scripture that do teach us to teach the next generation, including not only Deuteronomy chapter 6, but I want to direct your attention to Judges chapter 2. Because Judges chapter 2 gives us a very sober warning about what happens when we don't teach the next generation and when we don't teach one another the truth of God's Word. So I want to spend just a couple of moments with you on the book of Judges chapter 2, verse 10. And all that generation also were gathered to their fathers. And there arose another generation after them who did not know the Lord or the work that He had done for Israel. What is in view here is the generation of the Israelites who died in the wilderness, who did not come into the land because they did not obey the Lord, but they were in rebellion against God. But Joshua would bring a new generation into the land. And when he brought that generation into the land and established them there, there rose up after them a new generation that unfortunately did not know about the things of the Lord. So after that generation was gathered to their fathers, it goes on and says, another generation rose up after that generation that died and was gathered to their fathers, who did not know the Lord. And we know from the rest of the book of Judges the consequences of not knowing the Lord. To not know the Lord, to not be told, to not be taught who God is, what God has done, and what He requires of us to do in obedience to Him, means that the next generation will in fact be a terrible disaster. And that's what we see in the book of Judges. Immediately following this, in the book of Judges, we see the ongoing and persistent disobedience of the people of Israel. And so it goes on, and it's here says, know the Lord, or the work that he had done for Israel. The mighty deeds of God, the wondrous works of the Lord, the things that the Lord has done to save his people, and what requirements he makes of his saved people. That's the content that is needed for this generation and for the next in the days of Joshua and the judges. But it is also, of course, a need for this generation, the generation in which we're living, the generation in which you're living. It is required of us that we teach the next generation who God is, what God has done for us in his works of salvation, and then what duty he calls us to as those who have been saved by his grace. And so the Westminster Shorter Catechism is one tool. There are others. We could commend, of course, the Heidelberg Catechism as another wonderful tool that is faithful to the Scriptures, that is robustly reformed. And we could commend that to you in order that you might be able to instruct yourself and the next generation in who God is, what he has done, and what he requires of us. But in this class, we're going to be focusing in on the Westminster Shorter Catechism particularly, and we'll use the Catechism to introduce you to the teaching of the Catechism and the Reformed faith more generally. And so I would like to encourage you that as you continue to study through these lectures and you look at the Westminster Shorter Catechism, to not only learn about what the Reformed faith is, who God is, what he has done, and what he requires of us, but also to take that catechism and to use it in your life in instructing and teaching others, and especially the next generation, that another generation might not rise up that is ignorant of the things of God and what God calls us to do for his glory, and that we might, in fact, enjoy him forever.